Emma, for that beautiful piece of music. It gave me time to look out over the congregation and see all of the faces and spirits that are present here today. I'm going to ask a question before we begin, so it's this. Do any of you have a box of mints with you in your purse? If you can bring it up to me at some point. I left mine in my office. So today is Pentecost. As you can see, these beautiful red flowers, the red pyramids, the spirit and the flame, many in the congregation wearing red today or some color that is similar to red. Pentecost is the day that the Spirit was gifted to the early church. It was actually, in some people's minds, the birth of the church. And so we celebrate Pentecost 50 days after Easter, every year. If you are here today, or if you are online and part of our virtual community, a special welcome. May this service be a blessing. May you be fed and nourished and challenged and sent by the Word of God. May the Spirit be with you as well as the breath of God. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. And how many of you are actually rejoicing and being glad in it? This is an amazing weekend that God has gifted us with. We are gathered today in the name of God, our Creator, our Savior, and our Spirit. Amen. Please stand. Share the peace with your neighbor, and I'm going to ask you to look into their eyes and say with all confidence, the Lord be with you. So when you look at another person and say with all earnestness, the Lord be with you, does that feel different than just saying good morning? It's sort of our blessing at the beginning of the service. Today is Pentecost Sunday. Today the disciples were all gathered for this celebration of Shabbat, a festival celebrating the first fruits of the harvest. As they gathered, something new happened. The Holy Spirit moved through their gathering and stirred them to declare the good news of Jesus Christ in every native language of those gathered. Today, we are gathered to be a faithful community, to support one another, and to affirm God's gifts in each person. Creating God, unite and uplift us. We gather in the name to name the ways we both thrive and fall short as God continues to grow our faith. Lead us to love our neighbors as ourselves. Loving God, renew and reform us. Lord Jesus Christ, you send your Spirit into our lives. Stir us to new and bold actions, using the gifts that are abundantly present in this community. Help us to speak and act faithfully in ways our neighbors can hear and understand, so that they may know and experience your love and grace. We contemplate where the Spirit is leading us, and if you choose to, leading Vista. Awesome God, bless us as we worship you and make this gathering a place where we encounter you together. Gathered in the name of Jesus and alive in the Spirit, we pray that we would be comforted, disrupted, inspired, and strengthened in this time of worship. Holy God, mold us and move us. Amen. You may stand for the opening song. In the word of God, we pray together. Let us pray, O God. On this day, you open the hearts of your faithful people by sending into us your Holy Spirit. Direct us through that Spirit that we might have right judgment in all things and rejoice at all times in your peace. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Testament readings is from the second chapter of Acts. When the day of Pentecost had come, the apostles were all together in one place. And suddenly from heaven there came a sound like the rush of a violent wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues as of fire appeared among them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages as the Spirit gave them ability. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven living in Jerusalem. And at this sound, the crowd gathered and was bewildered, because each one heard them speaking in the native language of each. Amazed and astonished, they asked, "Are not all these who are speaking Galileans? And how is it that we hear, each of us, in our own native language? Parthians, Medes, Elamites, and residents of Mesopotamia, Judea and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and the parts of Libya belonging to Cyrene, and visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabs, in our own languages we hear them speaking about God's deeds of power. All were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, 'What does this mean?' But others sneered and said, 'They are filled with new wine.' But Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed them, 'Men of Judea and all who live in Jerusalem, let this be known to you, and listen to what I say. Indeed, these are not drunk, as you suppose, for it is only 9 o'clock in the morning. No, this is what was spoken through the prophet Joel. 'In the last days it will be,' God declares, 'that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. And your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. Even upon my slaves, both men and women, in those days I will pour out my spirit, and they shall prophesy.'" The second New Testament reading is from 1 Corinthians chapter 12. "No one can say, 'Jesus is Lord,' except by the Holy Spirit. Now there are varieties of gifts, but the same Spirit, and there are varieties of service, but the same Lord. And there are varieties of activities, but it is the same God who activates all of them in everyone. To each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. To one is given through the Spirit the utterance of wisdom, and to another the utterance of knowledge according to the same Spirit. To another, faith by the same Spirit. To another, gifts of healing by the one Spirit. To another, the working of miracles. To another, prophecy. To another, the discernment of spirits. To another, various kinds of tongues. To another, the interpretation of tongues. All these are activated by one and the same Spirit, who allots to each one individually, just as the Spirit chooses. For just as the body is one and has many members, and all the members of the body, though many, are one body, so it is with Christ. For in the one Spirit we were all baptized into one body, Jews or Greeks, slaves or free, and we were all made to drink of one Spirit." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand.
I shall be.
good news for today is recorded in St. John, the 20th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. This is Easter Sunday. When it was evening on that day, the first day of the week, and the doors of the house where the disciples had met were locked for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After he said this, he showed them his hands and his side, and then the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. And if you retain the sins of any, they are retained." The good news.
Praise to you, O Christ.
You may be seated. We don't have any children, but we'll sing the Kids Time song and we'll do a message for our virtual community where all of us can enjoy the gospel from a different perspective. Curious as to what I'm going to do with these. Have you ever had a breath mint? No? Everybody's had a breath mint? Why do you have a breath mint? Is it because we're afraid our breath is bad? Sometimes I have it just because I'm in the car and there's nothing else to do. But yes, we think we can have bad breath. Would you agree with that? I know I can have bad breath, especially if all I've had all morning is coffee, or after I have my favorite slice of cheese just by itself, Havarti. Sometimes by the end of the day, we need these. Can we have bad breath in God? What do you think? Bad breath in God? An icky taste in our mouth when we think about God, where we need a breath mint? I would say some of you are going, yeah, kind of, maybe. That would be our breath, wouldn't it? It wouldn't be God's breath. So in today's gospel lesson, Jesus breathed on them the Holy Spirit. I've always wondered what that looked like. Did he go up to them? And I apologize, I should take one of these first. But then I'd be sucking on it. He went up to this holy, to the adults, and he went, he breathed on them the Holy Spirit. Is that weird? Has anybody ever breathed on you on purpose? When my son was little, his dad used to breathe into his face on purpose, because when he did, Kyle would make this big noise. And he loved the face. So every time you turned around, Kyle was being breathed on. But that's not normal. We don't go around and breathe on each other. Now, when you breathe, what happens? Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. I'm hoping you don't need permission to breathe out. We don't even think about it most of the time. But when we breathe in, it goes where? Our lungs. And our lungs sends it through our blood to the rest of our body. There is no part of us that does not receive that breath. Have you ever thought about that? When Jesus breathed on the disciples and they breathed in that breath, the breath of God went into every pore of their being, and at the same time he said, "Receive the Holy Spirit." So where did the Holy Spirit go? Inside them. Into every pore of their being. That's kind of cool, isn't it? Have you ever done breath prayer? Anybody? I think you probably have. Did a parent or a grandma or a neighbor ever tell you, "Now, when you're upset, breathe in and breathe out five times, in and out, in and out, in and out." And what does it do? It calms you. I think that's breath prayer. I think that's the Spirit of God going in you and going, "It's going to be okay. It's going to be okay." So pray with me. Dear God, we thank you for breath. We thank you that every breath contains you. Calm us. Energize us. Give us life so that we might give it to others. Amen. Grace to you and peace from God our Creator and from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. So Pastor Dan is taking a weekend of recreation and Sabbath with his family this weekend. And we pray and we thank God for this beautiful weather. For him and everyone else that is at their cabins or in their gardens or traveling across country. When else did God breathe? Creation. The very first story. God took a lump of clay or dirt and breathed into it, and it became Adam. Did you know that the name Adam means earth or red earth or life? The very first story in biblical history of connection to other people was God breathing life into Adam. So God's breath from the very beginning has breathed new life into the world. How many of you thought you've heard this gospel lesson before? Like the second Sunday of Easter every single year? We have an abbreviated version of it today. We don't get to Thomas. We just get to Jesus showing up and breathing on the disciples and saying, "Peace be with you," and calming them down and then giving them a commission. So we look at it with a different lens and a different set of eyes. If you go back just a few days before this story is recorded, Jesus was on the cross, and one of the readings said, "And he breathed his last, and life went out of him." And that's where the disciples had left him, on a cross, taken off a cross, in an empty tomb. They had heard that he was alive, and then all of a sudden he was there. The disciples who had literally had the breath taken out of them. Have you ever grieved or cried so hard that it felt like you couldn't breathe? Like just wanting to go on was difficult. That's where the disciples were at. And then all of a sudden, Jesus appears in a locked room. Show me your breath when you're afraid. If all of a sudden you're startled or afraid, you go, and you can't breathe. Think about Jesus saying to you, peace be with you. Shalom. Wholeness. It's okay. And then they saw his hands, and they saw his side, and they believed, and then he said it again. Although this time it might have sounded different to them because he didn't need that confidence. He said, peace be with you. Shalom. Wholeness. Well-being. Whatever it is that you need. And then he commissioned them. And he breathed on them and said, receive the Holy Spirit. How many of you like this story? A God who gives his breath when we desperately need it, or calm, or energy, or life. Breath is sacred. Many of us have sat at the side of a friend or a parent or a loved one and watched them take their last breaths. And then they knew release to God. Many of us have been there at the birth of a child and heard the first breath and the first cry. We don't think about it. We just do it. And that's part of the story. God is saying it's so much more than that. I am in you. I am with you. You are never alone. And then he said something strange. So it's like, okay, peace be with you. How many of you like that? And he breathed on them the Holy Spirit. How many of you like that? And then he said, if you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven. And if you retain the sins of any, they are retained. How many of you like that? No, not a lot of people are. Do you even know what that means? Think about it. John is writing to a new community. And sin, at this time, as John is speaking to that new community, is disbelief. And retain or forgive is really, in Greek, release. If you release another person of their unbelief, they are released. Is that odd? What happens when we release them? We don't judge them. They could hear us differently. We're not looking at them and saying, ah. And if you don't release the unbelief, then they're not released. Is that odd? Jesus is commissioning them to go out into the world and to talk to other people and to release them from all of their fear and from all of their unbelief and from all of their life conditions and to invite them into something new. But not with a voice of judgment, because we've taken this verse and it's like, oh, you know, in the office of the keys it says right there when I was ordained, I can retain your sins. They say that to every new pastor. They read this and I've always gone, oh, I don't know what that means. And when I was really snarky, I would say to my brothers, if I was mad at them, you know, I can retain your sins. Why would we want to do that? Why want to release another person of all of their burdens so that they could have new life? So we take it and we make it into something different. It's kind of like Acts. So Jesus breathed on them and gave them the Holy Spirit, and the Pentecost happened. Pentecost is 50 days after Easter, and we go, oh, okay, that was clippy. He just went right ahead, and then they think that first Pentecost of the Holy Church was 3 years later, that the disciples needed that time to regroup. They were not going to be welcome in Jerusalem within 50 days. The Jewish leaders were still mad at them. The Romans were still mad at them. They were still the enemy. And it took them a long time to regroup and to be strong. And before this reading in Acts, they're in a room with 120 believers. Not just 12 and significant others and the women that surrounded them and people who followed, but 120 people. And in Acts 1, they're replacing Judas. It's taken them this long to say, okay, we're going to go forward. We're moving. And Matthias is the new disciple. We don't usually read that. They're doing the business of the church. They're praying. They're grouping as people. They're getting stronger. And then Pentecost happens. They have been indoors. They have been praying indoors as a community, and all of a sudden, they leave and they go outside. And then the Holy Spirit happens. And then everyone hears them in their own language. And then the miraculous happens and the church is born. But as long as they were in that closed room, or as long as they were gathered as 120 believers, nothing was going to happen. Not until they went outside. We're a community that's comfortable in here. We pray together. We support each other. This is a place where we are strengthened, but it's not just for here. It's so we go out there. So we go out there and we're not judgmental, and we share our love, and we share the gifts of the Spirit, and we share who we are, and we share, yes, who Jesus is. Because I don't know about you, but I believe there's a whole world that hasn't heard that message in a good way, because they really believe that what we do in here is talk about them and judge them. Whether it's the LGBTQIA plus community, whether it's people of color, single mothers, people who are suffering or trying to make a living, people who have made bad life choices. Those are the people we release and then embrace. In 2 weeks, we have Moving and Fed. Because we honestly believe that if this church is going to do the work of God, if the breath of God is in us, that we need to move outside of here. And our sermon series this summer is not about Peter or Paul or the big church leaders. It's going to be about all the little ones that we ignore that actually grew the church, that went outside of their worship service and invited other people in, the Lydia, the Phoebe, the Silas, the Barnabas. People of God who furthered mission. And not by being perfect preachers, but by showing God's love. Even Nicodemus, he'll be our first one. Because he's at the beginning of John, and did you know he's at the end? We always go, we don't know what happened to him. He was there when they took Jesus off the cross. He's the one that brought all of the spices for Jesus. journeys are all different. That's what this is about. Breathe in. Breathe out. We breathe in the Spirit of God, and we breathe out the Spirit of God. And maybe it's time we start breathing God's Spirit out a little bit better. Any of you agree with that? It's not that hard. God will lead us. To God be the glory. Amen. please stand for the Apostles' Creed? Together we proclaim our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven, and he is seated at the right hand of the Father. And he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. We prepare ourselves for God's table where we are fed. If you are at home, go into the kitchen, get a cracker, iced tea, juice, water, whatever it is you have, and join us in this very sacred meal. Our Lord Jesus, in the night in which he was betrayed, took bread and broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it to all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." We pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The table of our Lord is ready, and all are welcome at God's table. You may be seated. For those of you at home, the body of Christ given for you, the blood of Christ shed for you. Now may the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. We continue with prayers for our world. As we prepare for prayer, we continue, to pray for LeMay Cray, who is in her final stages of hospice, and for Yvonne Barton, who is recovering after a nasty fall with a broken hip and shoulder. So. Alive in Christ, filled with the Holy Spirit, let us pray for the church, the world, and all in need.
Passionate God, you send your Spirit through the gifts of fire, wind, and word to your community at large, and through quiet breath to each of us. As you equipped the faithful before us for their work, equip us to bring the good news to all those who long for you. Move in us, O God.
Fill us with faith.
Restoring God, your Spirit is at work in the world as we work toward restoration of our planet. We pray for those who work with wind energy, for migratory bird protections, for lands facing destructive fire, for those that know drought, and for new crops that feed your world. Renew the face of the earth. Move in us, O God.
Fill us with faith.
Ever-present God, Your Spirit embraces all. Send your Spirit of understanding to places that are troubled. We pray for communities suffering injustice and trauma on the third anniversary of George Floyd's murder. Our world knows. Help us to move in our lives and offer new life. Move in us, O God.
Fill us with faith. Merciful God, you anoint us with your Spirit. We are all instruments of healing, hope, and love. May we walk alongside those who know anxiety, stress, hopelessness, who are in life transitions, or who search for your presence and touch of hope. We pray for those who seek your comfort, especially those we now name, LeMay and Yvonne and their families, and all those that we now name silently in our hearts. Move in us, O God.
Fill us with faith. Generous God, you give us a wonderful variety of gifts. As Vista's council meets next weekend, give them your direction and we move forward in your name. To you always be the glory. Move in us, O God.
Fill us with faith.
Life-giving God, we give thanks for those who have died to new life in you. As we observe Memorial Day, we remember those who died in military service and name them in our hearts now. Comfort all who mourn and usher in the new world where all your people will work for peace. Move in us, O God.
Fill us with faith. Trusting in your presence in all things, we lift our prayers and praise to you, Almighty and Eternal God. Through Jesus Christ, our risen Savior. Amen. At this point, we share our offering.
Council, and we have a few announcements today. First, we thank God for the gift of Pentecost and the Pentecost Garden. Over here on this ledge over here, if you are going to pick up your flowers, please check off your name. All geraniums that are left after 2 weeks or indicated with a Vista name by it on the list will be planted here at Vista. Last Sunday, we had Emma's wonderful rendition of the green paper. I hope you took it to heart. How old you are, how many suggestions you have, right? So this is our last Sunday that we are asking for your input. Because the church council is meeting next Saturday for our retreat to determine our identity and focus on that. So please keep us, your church council, in your prayers as we meet on Saturday. On June 11th, as Pastor Heidi had mentioned, it's a special worship event called Moving and Fed. We are going to share with you in a brief report about our identity statement, which, not to say that we don't have an identity, but that we are just going to add words to our identity so that we can clearly say it. So please sign up at the welcome table or online, and there will be a link in the weekly update to bring a food item, and we're focusing on like a picnic style or a dessert. And if you're available for setup, please let us know. Mark is taking a long overdue vacation at that time. A couple of things during the week. Just a reminder that on Monday for Memorial Day, the office will be closed, so you cannot pick up your geraniums during the week on Monday, but otherwise you can pick them up anytime from 10 o'clock to 4 o'clock when the church is open. There is the Truth Over Tribe Book Club meeting on Wednesday, and we also have our STEP food collections on Tuesday and Saturday. And finally, may your Memorial Day be blessed, and we truly reflect on the meeting of Memorial Day.
Please stand and join the Spirit in our ascending song. Can't have it too many times. Peace be with you.
And also with you.
As we leave, God goes with us. Hear God's blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you all that you need in mind, body, spirit, relationship. And also give God's world everything it needs through us, the breath of God. In the name of God, our Creator, our Savior, and our Spirit. Amen. Go in peace. Experience God in your lives in unexpected ways. Live as an Easter people. Be a good neighbor and bless. bless God's world.
I will. Thanks be to God.